welcome to Wildwood Amphitheater. Man, it is awesome to see you all out here supporting live music, and you are for an incredible treat tonight. We have an artist that has played at Carnegie Hall. He's played all over the world, and now he's playing right here for you in Lake Orion, Michigan at Wildwood Amphitheater. So we are super excited about that. I want to just tell you before we get started that every Tuesday from now to the middle of August, we're going to have these free Tuesday night concerts. And there's also two very special events. On August 17th, we're bringing in several artists from Nashville for a night in Nashville here at Wildwood Amphitheater. It's a Saturday night. It's going to be an awesome, awesome show. And then my good friend Tim Sweet T. Williams is heading up the music for Ellopalooza, which is September 14th. Any of you watch The Voice? Sawyer Fredericks from The Voice is gonna be headlining that show. It's gonna be an awesome lineup as well. But tonight, really one of the nights that we've been looking forward to all summer, this gentleman played over at our venue at 20 Front Street a couple of times, and every time he's played there, I get tons of messages where people are saying, please bring him back. And who here has seen Dave Bennett before? Yeah, so you know what I'm talking about. All right, without further ado then, let's welcome Dave Bennett Quartet. Thank you.
one here at Wildwood. Did everybody hear what I just said? Okay, thanks, Evan. Just want to say thank you once again for having us here tonight. This is our first time performing here at Wildwood, and we want to thank 20 Front Street, Lake Orion, and everyone here for being so gracious to us. This is really a beautiful place. Before we go any further, I just want to see by a show of hands, how many of you have either seen us before or this is your first time? Okay. That's good. I just like to get a feel for how this is going to go, you know. Anyway, for those of you who have seen us before, this past year has been a very incredible one. There's been a lot of good things happen in our professional career. And over the course of this evening, we're going to be sharing some of that news with you. We hope you enjoy the show that we have planned for you. We opened up with a song that was a big hit for the Beatles, and that was called Eleanor Rigby. And we'd like to take you down to New Orleans for this next one. It's a real funky thing they play down there during Mardi Gras. And but it's one of these songs that not a lot of people know, but I absolutely love playing songs that nobody knows. I really do, because you're less likely to know when I screw them up. So, this was a big hit for Pete Fountain. We hope you enjoy it. It's called Down in Honky Tonk Town. Thank you. Thank you very much, everybody. Hey, I mean, we gotta watch it. These mics are not on when I go up to them. We gotta make sure they stay on, okay? Thank you. So everybody, one of the cool things we had happen this year is we released a new album on Mack Avenue Records. And it's the first time we did a project that features primarily original material. And we're very grateful to say that this, about a year and a half ago, it reached number 24 on the Billboard Jazz chart. So things are really going the right way. A lot of good blessings have come our way. We're very grateful for it. So we would like to play the title track off of our latest recording. And this is a song that I wrote about 4 years ago. And we really hope you enjoy it. It's called Blood Moon. And I just gotta tell you, we absolutely love it when an audience applauds for the song before we play it. Because just in case you don't like what you hear, at least we have the memory of that applause just kind of dying off into our memories. Thank you. very much, everyone. Well, at this time, I would like to introduce the guys that we have performing for you on stage tonight. Starting over here on my right, coming all the way from DeWitt, Michigan, this gentleman has been on the road with me for the last 6 years or so, and he also arranges music for Michigan State, Central Michigan, and he does quite a bit of my arranging. So he's a lot of fun to have around, and very grateful to have him with us tonight. So please say hello to Mr. Jeff Kressler. Back here at the electric bass, coming from the Lansing area, he's also been on the road with me for about as long as Jeff has, and we've been having a great time going around the country performing jazz, blues, rock and roll, and whatever the opportunity calls for. This guy can play any type of music there is, and very grateful to have him. So please welcome Ed Fidoa. The guy sitting behind the drums is someone that I've been sharing the stage with for quite a long time now. I've been performing with him since I was 15 years old. And the amazing thing about it is at that time, he was only 16. However, he lived a little bit of a harder life than I did on the road, and that's all we're gonna say about that. But he hates it when I do this because Doug doesn't like the limelight. He doesn't like being thrown out amongst the paparazzi and the crowd and everything, because they all adore him, you know? But he was featured as one of the top five drummers from the Detroit area in Downbeat magazine. So please welcome Doug Cobb at the drums. My name is Dave Bennett. I come from Waterford, Michigan. Thank you so much for having me. All right, well, we'd like to do something right now that's either very brave or very stupid. We don't know which one yet, but we're going to compose a song for you as we play it. So hang on to your seats. Here we go. I should also mention this. You see this piano bench that Jeff Kressler is sitting on? Well, we played the Elkhart Indiana Jazz Festival this past June. And for those of you who've seen us before, you know that sometimes when I do a song by Jerry Lee Lewis, I have a tendency to, get carried away and abuse some of the instruments that I've been performing on. So there's been one or two piano benches that have kind of taken a beating, and the production team actually took it upon themselves to make me my own piano bench. This is made of solid steel. It's got my name embroidered in it. You could put an elephant on this thing and it won't break, so we're gonna have some fun with this. Yeah, they all signed it on the bottom there. So it's very comfortable. Do you like it, Jeff? Yeah, all right, here we go. Thank you. for Jeff Kressler. If you're interested, after the show, up there at the top of the hill, we have our good friend Mandy, who is sitting right here in the front, and she will be selling our CDs that feature all the music you're hearing here tonight. So if you'd like to come talk to her, please say hello. She's taking a week off from the convent this weekend to help us. And we'd be more than happy to autograph any merchandise you like. Just keep in mind that when we do that, it reduces the value by about 13%. So this next song was written by Jimmy Webb, and it was a big hit for Glenn Campbell, and we hope you enjoy our rendition. This is called Wichita Lineman. Thank you.
just say no. You say you don't like it, but you can't hide your desire. Cause when we kiss in fire,
this next song we're going to do for you is something that's very near and dear to the heart of our drummer. And it goes to a very special private place for him. This is a song about a place called Folsom Prison. And while Doug didn't actually stay at Folsom, it was something similar. It wasn't official, but it was Jackson, is that it? Okay. So we would like to play a song in tribute for our drummer, the outlaw, Doug Cobb. This is called Folsom Prison Blues. There's rich folks eating in a fancy dining car. Let you know that if you'd ever like to come see us perform again, we spend about 80% of our lives traveling around the country, sometimes Canada, and this September touring season starts up pretty heavy. We're going to be in Sacramento for about 3 days. We come home for 1 day, literally do our laundry, then we fly back to Penticton, British Columbia for 5 days. Then we're going to be doing about a week's worth of shows down in Grosse Pointe. Then we go back to Edmonton, Alberta, to be featured with the symphony. So things are gonna get pretty crazy. But for the remainder of the summer, we're gonna be around here quite a bit. You can follow us at davebennett.com, where you can sign up for our monthly newsletter. You can also find us at Facebook and Instagram. So that way, if there's a particular date where you know you see that we're near you, you can come out and see us, or you can choose to stay home. People have done both. But this next song we'd like to do for you is another original, and there's a little story that goes behind this. Now, when I started playing professionally, I was very young. I was 13 years old, and at that time, no one ever questioned my age when I was performing at coffee houses and sometimes bars, because I basically looked 35 years old ever since I was in the eighth grade, but everything's evening out now. So the manager of this one place I used to play at advertised me in the local paper as David 13 Fingers Bennett. He just hung that name on me. But I was also performing the music of Benny Goodman primarily, which we still do quite a bit of that to this day. So I thought, wouldn't it be cool to write a song that would be in Benny's style, that maybe if he were alive today, he might do something like this. So we hope you enjoy this next one. It's a crazy little song called 13 Fingers. And I should mention to you that the other night, right before we played this, back here at the drums, Doug Cobb whispered to me that he thinks this is what killed Benny. Thank you. Thank you very much. We'd like to play a fast one for you now.
Thank you.
Now, this next song I'd like to do for you, it was the very first song that I ever wrote. And we recorded this on an album called Whole Lot of Shakin', which featured the music of Sun Records in the 1950s. You had Jerry Lee Lewis, Chuck Berry, Carl Perkins. But we hope you enjoy this one. This is called Lonesome Highway.
Driving down this road, looking for a friend. Down a road that has no end. Oh, I'm trapped.
Comes the moment I know you've all been waiting for, and that would be to feature our drummer. Oh yeah. You know, before we do that, I just wanted to say that at some of our shows recently, we've had some issues with bootlegging, and you know, we take very seriously the music that we perform for you, and some of the songs we're performing tonight haven't even been released yet. So we're just asking that, out of respect for the band, if you are bootlegging, please don't miss these songs. Because they're good. They're the good ones. Now, this next song was something that we had the opportunity to perform at Carnegie Hall about 6 years ago. And believe it or not, I don't like embarrassing people, but we have a very dear friend of ours who was actually one of the stagehands the night that we played at Carnegie Hall. And that'll be our friend Liz up here in the front. So Liz, we want to say we love you and thank you for supporting us and being our friend. And I told her, if you come back to one of our shows, we'll promise to get it right. So I'd like to feature Doug Cobb on this next one, and this is called Sing, Sing, Sing. Sing.
Thank you.
time for a couple more songs for you. And right now, we'd like to pay tribute to one of my favorite rock and roll piano players. He's going to be 84 next month, and unfortunately, a stroke has slowed him down a few months ago, but up until that time, he was still touring. So we'd like to pay tribute now to the killer, Mr. Jerry Lee Lewis. Can you hear this okay? Okay. One time we were performing at a music festival, and they misprinted the program and said we were doing a tribute to Jerry Lewis. There is a difference.
Play for me, brother.
To the conclusion of our show. We've had a wonderful time tonight, one of the best times we've had in ages. If we can ever come back and perform for you, we will be here in a heartbeat. I'd like to thank 20 Front Street. I want to thank everybody here at Wildwood. everyone here in Lake Orion for being so kind to us. We really appreciate it. If you could do me a big favor, if you can give Jeff and Ed and Doug a big round of applause for me. As soon as we get done performing, right up there at the top of the hill, we have our good friend Mandy, who is selling our CDs. We're also going to stick around and say hi, if you'd like to say hello to us, for a couple of reasons. We really love you. We're very grateful for the love you've shown us. But for the most important reason, is we don't have very many friends. We need them very desperately. So if you can help us out, that'd be great. Tomorrow night at 7 o'clock p.m. until 10, we're going to be in Mount Clemens performing at the Rec Bowl. If you get a chance to check that out, it's on my website. And then I'm off to Davenport, Iowa to perform at the Big Spiderback Jazz Festival. So, folks, we love you. God bless you. Have a great night. We'll see you soon, all right? Thanks a lot.
I just wanted to thank everyone for coming out. Is this a great place or what? You don't even have to rush off because there's no traffic jam because it's such a great size venue. So we only have 4 shows left this year and we don't have a very big advertising budget. So we had about 550 people here tonight. If each person brought one person with them, the next 2 Tuesdays, we'd have 1,100 people out here, which would be awesome. So who's gonna bring some people for us? All right. And then we have 2 very special ticketed shows coming up, and we really need your support on these. If you like country music, August 17th, we have a night in Nashville with terrific country artists coming from Nashville, Tennessee to spend the night with you. It's a Saturday, it's August 17th. Please go on the 20 Front Street website, 20frontstreetweb.com, and buy tickets to that. And then my good friend Shannon here is going to tell you quickly about Allopalooza, which is the last concert of the season out here at Wildwood.
Thank you, Alan. Hi, everyone. I wanted to let you know Allopalooza is coming up September 14th, and we have Sawyer Fredericks from The Voice coming to headline, and a lot of other amazing talent from Michigan. And all of the proceeds will benefit the Miracle League North Oakland field that's being built right here in Friendship Park. And also, please come out on August 9th to the grand opening. There will be live music and fireworks, and that is at Friendship Park on August 9th. For the Allopalooza tickets, you can purchase those online for only $15 at allopalooza.org. Please spread the word and tell all of your friends to come out. Thank you.
Okay, thank you so much, Lake Orion. See you next Tuesday.